Hi my dear friends, welcome back to Gurudev online classes. Last class we learnt about the from the topic of materials, metals and non-metals. One of the chemical properties of the metals and non-metals, that is the metals and non-metals, materials are react with the oxygen to formation of the oxide. That metal oxides are the basic in nature and non-metal oxides are acidic in nature. Okay, this is the one of the chemical properties of the materials, metals and non-metals. Another one chemical properties of the materials, that is the reaction with water. Okay, that metals and non-metals are reacts with the water and to formation of and the new compound is formed. Okay, observe here that reaction with water, that so many metals are there, that is the sodium is also one of the metal. Okay, these sodium metals are easily react with the water. No, this is not, this sodium is stored in the kerosene. Why we are stored in the kerosene? Because of the sodium is easily react with the air and easily react with the water also. This is a very high reactive element, high reactive compound. So we are stored in the kerosene. The sodium are stored in the kerosene. Okay, this sodium is one of the metal. Observe here, this sodium metal is a very reactive metal and this is the stored in the kerosene and some other materials are, you know, some other materials are do not react with the water. For example, iron is not react with the water. It react with the water slowly. It means it takes some time. But sodium is easily react with the water. When we the small pieces of sodium is kept into the water, that is easily reacted. Some sound are evaporated when we are kept into sodium piece into water. That that sodium are reactive. That some gases also releases. Hydrogen gases is releases. Okay, observe here. This is the sodium. This sodium is react with the water. With a small piece of sodium, this kept into the water, that formation of the sodium hydroxide. Sodium hydroxide means NaOH. This is the chemical formula of the sodium hydroxide, NaOH. When this sodium and water reacts to the formation of the another one gases also releases, that is the hydrogen. No, sodium hydroxide also releases. This is also one of the new compound and hydrogen gases is liberated when the sodium and water is mixed. Okay, this is one of the reaction. You know, the sodium is one of the metals. It means that most of the sodium and most of the metals are react with the water, liberated the hydrogen gases and the sodium hydroxides. Some hydroxides are liberated. Okay, this is the reaction with the that metals react with the water. And another one, non-metals. Non-metals like phosphorus, this is the non-metal. This is also high reactive element, high reactive compound. But this is not stored in the kerosene. This is stored, in the water. Why? Because this phosphorus is react with the air. Fastly react with the air. It means the when it absorbs the fire catches, it fire catches phosphorus, fire catches easily, so we are stored in the water. But sodium metals are stored in the kerosene, phosphorus non-metals are stored in the water because this is not react with the water. Means most of the non-metals are not react with the water because we are stored in the water. Okay, that phosphorus are stored in the water. This is one of the one chemical reaction of the metals and the non-metals. It means this is the sodium is a metal, phosphorus is the non-metal. Sodium is easily react with the water, that phosphorus is a non-metal. This is not easily react with the water. It reacts with the air, but this is the react with the water easily. And that hydrogen gases are liberated. Okay, this is the one chemical reaction, chemical properties. Okay. The next one concept, that is the properties of the chemical properties of the metals and non-metals, that is the reaction with acids. Okay, that metals or non-metals are react with acid. Observe here that metals are react with acids. It produces the hydrogen gases. Metals are react with acids, it produces the hydrogen gases, but non-metals are not react with the acids. This is the one of the chemical properties. When how to observe this metals are react with the acids and this liberated the hydrogen gases. How to observe? We have take a matchstick that hold on the metals, hold on that matchstick gives us some pop sound. That pop sound react with the that acids or metals are react with the acids. You know, matchsticks are hold on the test tube of the metals are react with the acid. Anyone acid. That gives the one pop sound. That pop sound is called the indicated the metals are releases the hydrogen gases. Okay, this is a very very important property, chemical properties of the metals. And the copper, this do not react with the dilute hydrochloric acid. This is the react with the sulfuric acid. You know, this copper, this is the one of the metal. This metal is do not react with the hydrochloric acid. Already I told that most of the metals are react with the acid, react with the acids, but copper, this is also one of the metal, is it right? This do not react with the dilute hydrochloric acid, but this is react with the sulfuric acid. You know, sometimes that copper, sometimes metals do not react with the acid. Some metals are, yes, almost all metals are easily reacted with the acid. Okay, that another one properties of the non-metals and non-metals, that is the reaction with the bases. Already we learned reaction with acids. These metals are react with the acids, it produces the hydrogen gas. Non-metal metals are not react with the acids, this not produces any gases. Okay, then we are identified by the matchstick. You know that pop sound, indicates, pop sound is indicates the that metals are react with the produces the hydrogen gas. You know, reaction with the bases, reaction with bases, you know, observe that metals and metals is react with the bases. You know that, for example, sodium hydroxide, this is the one of the base. Okay, this metal, anyone metals, these metals are react with the sodium hydroxide. This is also produces the hydrogen gas. You know, we are identified by the that matchstick, that pop sound, that indicates the hydrogen gases producers. When that sodium hydroxides or hydroxide react with the metals to formation of the hydrogen gases. In this, metals also react with the bases. In that time also hydrogen gases is liberated. Okay, that but non-metals are not react with the any hydroxides or any bases. Okay, this is the one of the third chemical properties of the metals and non-metals. The next one, properties, physical properties, already we are learnt about that. You know that is the metals and non-metals are react with the bases. Okay, that is the complex. You know that non-metals are react with the bases, that is the complex. Okay, observe here. You know, one of the concept of displacement reaction. Displacement reaction takes place in the non-metals are react with the bases. Observe here. You know that metals are displaces. You know, changes the position. Just only changes the position. Displacement means it changes the position to other position. You know, observe here that copper sulfate and zinc. Observe here, these are copper sulfate and react with the zinc to formation of the zinc sulfate and produce the copper. Okay, observe here that copper sulfate zinc replaces. You know that copper places are the zinc are replaces the copper place. Okay, this is the, you know, that zinc sulfate, the formation of zinc sulfate is the copper. It means this is the displaces the other metal from aqueous solution. Displaces, you know, that zinc displaces the copper position to formation of the zinc sulfate, and copper is will be separated. Okay, observe here copper sulfate, that when we are adding the iron nails, that iron, that Fe replaces the copper, displaces the copper place. Okay, you know that ferrous sulfate is formation and copper is separated. It means the, you know, this is the one of the displacement reaction. Observe here, we have taken, let us do one activity about the displacement reaction. Now we can take in 5 beakers. In this beaker, we have to fill in 50 ml of the water is poured into 5 beaker. Okay, this is a 5 beaker. You know, the first one beaker, we have added copper sulfate and zinc granules are kept into the first one beaker A. Beaker A. Okay, that second one beaker, this contains copper sulfate and iron nail. Copper sulfate and iron nail. Iron nail means iron, Fe. Okay, copper sulfate, CuSO4. Copper sulfate, zinc, Zn. This is the one of the chemical formula of the compounds. Observe here, and this beaker A contains the copper sulfate and zinc granules. It means Zn. Okay, CuSO4 plus Zn are present in the beaker A. Next one, beaker B contains zinc sulfate and iron nails are kept into the beaker B. Okay, this contains the beaker B contains the copper sulfate plus iron nail, means Fe. That chemical formula, chemical name of the iron is the Fe. Okay, this copper sulfate plus iron nail are present in the beaker B. Okay, third one beaker contains the zinc sulfate plus copper terminals. You know, zinc sulfate plus copper. Okay, that fourth one beaker D contains the ferrous sulfate FeSO4, ferrous sulfate and copper terminals. Okay, ferrous sulfate FeSO4 and copper is present in the beaker D. Okay, beaker E contains zinc sulfate. Zinc sulfate means ZnSO4. ZnSO4 plus iron nail. Iron nail means Fe. Iron means Fe. Okay, zinc sulfate and iron nail is present in the beaker E. Okay, after we can observe, you know, that copper sulfate, zinc, this copper sulfate and zinc are react with to formation of the zinc sulfate. Okay, this is the reaction with formation of the zinc sulfate and the copper sulfate and iron nails. This is formation of the ferrous sulfate. Okay, but in these three, beaker number, beaker C, beaker D, beaker E do not react. Why? These beaker A and B is easily react. It means it takes place the displacement reaction. Observe here, copper that displaces, zinc is displaces the copper position. Observe, this is zinc sulfate. Zinc sulfate means this is the copper position, this is the zinc position. No, the copper zinc is displaces to copper position. You know, ZnSO4 formation. Okay, this is the displacement reaction. In this beaker, second beaker, this is also same displacement reaction that takes place in the second beaker. Now observe the copper sulfate and ferrum iron. You know that formation of the FeSO4. You know that iron or Fe the ferrum. Places the copper position to formation of the FeSO4. But beaker number C, D, E, this is not react. Why these are not react? You know, observe here that copper and zinc, these are the metals. Observe these metals are, you know, the zinc is more reactive than the copper because this displaces easily. In this beaker B, ferrous or iron is more reactive than the copper, so it displaces easily. But in zinc, you know, copper is not more reactive with the zinc, so it is not displaces. In that position also, not displaces. It means anyone displaces that more reactive than the copper, so easily displaces. It means that copper is not reactive, less reactive, so it is not displaces in the position of zinc, so it is not reactive. And copper is not more reactive than the zinc, so this is not reactive, and this is also not reactive. In this, it means any one chemical reaction, displacement reaction, it depends upon the reactive than the copper or reactive than the other metals. It means this is the displacement reactions are easily takes place. Observe, you know, zinc, this is the copper, you know, the copper sulfate and zinc. Zinc is high reactive than the copper, so this displaces easily. No, in the ferrous, this highly reactive compound, this easily displaces to position of copper. Okay, but this copper is less reactive, is not displaced easily. You know that ferrous is not less reactive compared to the zinc, is not reactive. Okay, this is the one of the properties. This is the displacement reactions that takes place in the metals and non-metals. In the last concept of this chapter, that is the uses of metals and non-metals. Okay, so many uses of metals is there. That the metals are used in different fields. Okay, metals are used to make different machineries. Big machines are made by the metals. Okay. For example, in the transport, the transport is completely depends upon the metals, and that most utensils also is made by the metals. Okay, observe here that different machines also made by the metals, and these metals are used in the automobiles. You know, because of these have different physical properties and different chemical properties. You know, easily to make a different shape. You know that this have the malleable character and ductile character. So easily to make a different shape. So we are uses in the automobiles, uses in the aeroplane also. Construction of aeroplane is made by the metals and some utensils. Most of the utensils also made by the metals. And trains, completely train is depends upon the metal. You know, iron, that is made by the iron. that is iron is one of the metal. This completely the train is made by the metals and satellites in the field of the satellites, cooking utensils, because we are using the cooking utensils. That cooking utensils are helpful to conducting the heat and electricity heat. You know, because we are using the cooking utensils. Metals are used for making cooking utensils and boilers. Already we know that boiler, this is made by the metals. Why that metals are used to make the boiler? Because of the it help to conduct the heat, it help to conduct the electricity also. These character, these physical characters are present in the metals. Okay, that is we are used for making boiler and cooking utensils also. Okay, in so many uses of the metals also is there, and some uses of non-metals also is there. Okay, because that is non-metals, that uses of non-metal. Okay, non-metals also uses, you know, not only metals are uses, some metal, non-metals also very useful to human kind. Okay, that most of the all living organisms are, that depends upon the that non-living, non-metals. Okay, that this metal, all living organisms are depends upon the non-metals during the breathing, inhalation and exhalation is depends upon the non-metals. And these non-metals are used to for making fertilizers. That fertilizers are increases the soil fertility. That soil, when soil fertility increases, that automatically that plants are grow. It means that fertilizers is helpful to plants. This non-metals are helpful to plants. That most of the non-metals are used to for useful for living organisms. And this is a water purification process. These non-metals are used in the water purification methods, and it is used in the purple colored solution. Purple colored solution means that is one of the antiseptic. This used for wound. Okay, as a wound, this is the antiseptic. It means the purple colored solution is used making by the non-metals, and this is used in the crackers. Okay, these are the different uses of the metals and non-metals. Okay, this chapter is now completed. Thank you.